hospital. She'd been pretty sick for about half a year. Things at the time, the immaturing kid. I dropped the lines and jumped the next London train. I found her laid up and in a lot of pain. Her eyes were mine and then I understood. The weather forecast wasn't looking too good. The sadness from her stories for a little while. I tried to whisper and tried to raise a smile. She silenced all my ramblings with a shake of her head. Pull me close to listen, this is what she said now. You'll live to dance another day. Cause now you'll have to dance for the two of us. So stop looking so damn depressed. And sing with all your hearts. The queen is dead, yeah. She told me she was sick of all the hospital food. Of doctors and relatives draining her blood. She said, I know I'm dying, but I'm not finished just yet. I'm dying for a drink and for a cigarette. We hatched a plan to book ourselves a cheap hotel. The center of the city and to great some LA waste through all the clubs and when everyone else is all asleep. Then we know it could end. Working on some words and Sarah called me up. She said that Lex had gone to sleep and wasn't waking up. And even though I knew there was nothing to be done, I felt bad for not being there and now well, she was gone. I tried to think what Lex would want me to do in times like this when I was feeling blue. I gathered up some friends, spread the sad, sad news. We headed to the city for a drink or two. We sang, we'll live to dance another day. It's just now we'll have to dance for one more of us. So stop looking so with all your
heart. Long live the Queen. Thank you so much. Thank you.